Superheroes are not only found in the movies. Those who are taking initiative to help underprivileged peoples are also known as superheroes. What is food, water, and energy nexus? Food, water, and energy are three systems interconnected. The nexus is how and where these three systems are intersect. Because actions related to one system, it may impact on one or both other systems as well. So it is necessary to take a nexus approach. There are many challenges facing by the farmers to get the water supply in their farming region.
Some of the farmers are still using the supply of pipe water to their plants, which is high in energy and time consumption, because they need to pay for the water that they are using for their plant. Besides that, they also have another alternative options, which they use water from the pond as well. We are in the situation where some of them were complaining, while some celebrating the rain. Why don't we use the rainwater to produce hydroelectricity? Hydroelectricity is the best solution to help the underprivileged people. Hydroelectricity is the term referring to the electricity generated by hydropower, the production of electrical power through the use of gravitational force of falling or flowing of water. Let's look at how the hydropower is generated.
Precipitation in the form of snow, rainfalls in the catchment area of the scheme. A catchment area is any part of the land where water drains to the lowest part. Water from the melting snow and the rain is collected and stored behind the dams in lakes and reservoirs, and then diverted through tunnels and pipelines down to the power stations, hundreds of meters below. In its simplest form, electricity is generated by a rotating magnet inside a wire coil. In a power station, this process is enhanced. The magnet is an electromagnet or rotor spinning inside the fixed coils or stator of the generator. This generator is mounted on a vertical shaft above the turbine, and the water is used to drive the turbine, which operates the generator. Transformers boost generated voltage to a level that can be economically transmitted over long distances by transmission lines to the towns and cities. The guide vanes control the volume of water required to drive the turbine and thereby determine the amount of electrical power produced. Once the water has passed through the turbines in the power stations, it is released into rivers to be used to irrigate farms in the dry regions.
Besides producing electricity, the rainwater also can play an important role in increasing the crop yield. Therefore, we can say that the nexus approach is achieved, where the suggested solution may involve of food, water, and energy.